What is up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. You guys, in this video, what I'm going to do, this is going to be kind of a longer tutorial type of video. So some of you guys are looking for, you know, a freaking wham, bam, thank you, ma'am type of quickie. This ain't going to be that video, because what I'm doing in this one is I'm helping out a buddy of mine put together his email sequence. And I just thought I'd shoot a quick video and kind of walk you guys through my thought process and really just the overall strategy. This is for people that are looking to capture leads for businesses. So for businesses that are looking to capture leads online through some type of maybe online traffic, Facebook advertising, you know, Instagram advertising, YouTube advertising, whatever. If you're driving traffic to some type of offer, right? And really this applies to, it applies to any business, but really the type of business where you're either offering some type of, maybe you're a local business owner, you're a local gym, you're a local yoga studio, you're a local dentist, you're a local restaurant, you're a local freaking dry cleaner, anything, you're a local real estate agent, you're a local insurance agent, anything that you can put together in the form of a PDF or maybe even a video. PDF tends to work really great when you can give away some type of free download, when you can run an ad, get people to click on it, go to your webpage where there's some type of free offer in the form of a PDF, which AKA is just simply information on that topic, information on your business, information on that specific service, or product, right? Whenever you can give away free information, people tend to gravitate to it, and they're willing to give up their information, their name, email. Normally, that's it. You don't want to ask for too much more information than name and email. You can go for phone number, but your conversion will be much lower, because people are willing to give up their name and email all damn day for things that they're interested in, but their phone number, we're still hesitant to give up a phone number, right? So name, email is all you want to do. A person goes to your webpage, they see your ad, they click on it, they enter their name and email to download a free document, a free tip sheet, a free guide, some type of free PDF that gives them information on what they're interested in. That right there, from a business perspective, is an amazing way, and it's been an amazing way for many years now, to capture leads, right? To capture leads. Now, once you capture the lead, depending on what type of business you're in, you may be looking to make a sale. So if I go to your page and I see something for free, I enter my name and email, I download it, I then go to what we call a thank you page, which is a confirmation page, you know, thank you for downloading whatever. In order to really maximize your profits, right? And to really offset your advertising cost, because this is not something you can just take to social media. Like, it's not something where you could just post your link on your personal Facebook page and all of a sudden people are going to buy or download your offer. A lot of times organic traffic is not going to work for you. So you absolutely have to be running paid ads, right? So no matter what the offer is, you want to maximize that with some type of call to action on the thank you page. So on that confirmation page, if you're in the business of appointments, what I'm going to show you right here how we're setting up a simple page to maximize appointments. Either let's say you're in the business of making a sale. Okay, so I go to your page, I enter my name and email, I download the free guide, 10 tips to lose weight, 10 tips to run faster, 10 tips to slam dunk a freaking basketball, 10 tips to freaking stretch, whatever the offer, whatever the service, there could be an offer. There could be some type of free PDF that you're giving out to capture leads, man. This is how you're going to build a business online. So again, when I go to that thank you page, depend on what you're trying to do, depend on your business. You may be maybe trying to sell me something, right? Getting me to buy something right then and there. You got my attention with the free PDF. Now, because I need this other thing that you know that I'll need, maybe you try to sell it to me there, right? So right away, you're going for the sell after they downloaded the free offer, right? You could be in that type of a business. But if you're in the type of business where you're shooting for appointments, and this is what I'm going to show you today, that today's example is going to be me working on my buddy's page and email sequence, because he's in the business of appointments. So if you're an insurance agent, if you're a real estate agent, if you're a dentist, right, you're trying to get people to schedule appointments for a free teeth cleaning, right? Whatever it may be, the thank you page and your email sequence is where you're going to get the appointments from. Okay. So what I'm going to show you here is how we're going to make all that happen, but I'm going to show you the technical side of it all. That's why it's going to be kind of a longer tutorial type of video, because it's going to be more of me showing you the technical side of it all, right? Let me go ahead and share my screen. So real quick, if you're into this kind of stuff, man, if you're into social media marketing, Facebook advertising, making money online, building a business online, capturing a lead online, you're in the right place. My name is David. I'm out here in San Diego building an online business and doing all the above. So subscribe, smash the bell for notifications, and drop me a comment below. Let me know where you guys are coming from and let me know how I can bring value to what you're doing online. All right. So let me walk you through this and I'll kind of give you my two cents as we're going through it. The platform and the software that I use for my email automation, for my landing pages, and for my online calendar is this one software right here. So for those of you that are using other online softwares, other landing page softwares, majority of them come with just the landing page. Then you got to go get another software for your email automation. And then you got to go get a third software for your online calendar, right? I do everything inside of this one. So what I would highly encourage you to do is activate a 14-day trial. There's a link in the description, profitwithkartra.online. Activate a 14-day trial and simply compare it to what you're using. And I guarantee you, man, it's night and day. I'm going to show you how simple this is, all inside of one platform. The landing page, the email autoresponder, and the online calendar. That's what we're going to be working on today. Okay, so let me walk you through this and let me kind of show you what I'm about to do. All I'm going to do is put together a sequence. Okay. So I'm going to put together some email sequences. These are the automated emails that go out after someone downloads the free PDF. Okay. So let me kind of walk you through this. Let me click on pages. And then what I'm going to also open up is I'm going to open up, calendars. So I'm going to right click, open link in new tab. I'm going to open up calendars. And then also I'm going to hover over my communications, right click, open in new tab, my communications. So I have open to play around with my pages. I have over here the calendar, and then I have over here the email automation. Okay, this is where we have our leads, our list, and our sequence. That's where we're going to be. That's our autoresponder, our sequences. Okay, so I'm going to be in these three tabs and kind of just again walking you through it. Okay, so but let me show you where it all starts. Let me show you where it all begins. Okay, in this case, this is his landing page. Okay, so what he's going to be doing is running Facebook ads targeting restaurant owners. This guy is building an agency. Shout out to my boy, Boyan. Shout out to him, man. Shout out to B. Coachable, teachable, one of my clients, and simply just absorbing all the game I'm giving them when it comes to social media marketing and Facebook advertising. So I couldn't be more fired up and excited for him. I'm super happy for him. He's come a long way learning all this stuff, having to deal with me as a coach is not always easy. So shout out to him, man, for putting all this together and really about to crush it, right? So he's going after and building an agency around restaurants. He wants to start bringing value to restaurants and getting them as clients to simply service them when it comes to Facebook advertising and social media marketing. So he'll be running Facebook ads to a landing page, which will be this page right here, which I already see a mistake. We got to put a space in between this. I'm just big on details like that, but he'll be running traffic, right? Facebook advertising to this page to get people to download his free book, 5 Tips How to Get More Customers for Your Restaurant Using Facebook. Okay. So this is an awesome, awesome page right here, that I simply, freaking gave him. This was one of my pages that I simply just transferred over to his account. That's the good thing about Kartra, man. I could build out all these damn funnels, all these sequences, all these pages, all this stuff, save it and simply transfer it to a new person's account. So again, if you guys activate a 14-day trial, click the link in the description, profitwithkartra.online, activate a 14-day trial. I'll send you so many damn funnels to help you, get off to a fast start. It's not even funny. This was one of the funnels that I sent him. So this is a simple page that he has here, driving traffic to download the free ebook. Okay. So now when people come here and download the book, they enter their name and email. They're then taken to this page over here. They're then taken to the thank you page. And here's what I'm going to do, actually, now that I really look at this. I'm going to simply edit this color real quick. This right here. Actually, you know what? I'll do that later. I'll do that later because I got to save the color. I got to save the color. But what I wanted to do was match this, match the blue that's on the landing page, match it with the blue that's over here. You have this teal. He has this teal blue over here that I want to change. I want to change out and have it match the landing page. That's the thing, man. When it comes to the details, when it comes to the aesthetics of everything, your colors, your font, your email templates, your footer, try to keep a lot of this stuff the same. You want that consistency in your branding. It goes a long, long way, right? So don't take me to a landing page where it was dark blue and then now I come here and it's this teal blue, right? So we'll change that out. No big deal. We'll change that out. But let me just simply show you this thank you page. This is what it's all about. Okay, so this is what I'm going to show you. This is how we get appointments. Or again, if you're in an e-commerce type of business and you have a physical product or you're selling a service, you know, right away, and you want to sell me something right away, you could totally do that too. But in this case, we're shooting for an appointment. Okay, so he's driving traffic to his landing page to download a free PDF. Once they enter their name and email, they come here where all he's saying is he's saying thank you. He's introducing himself. He's telling them to check their email because he just sent them their free PDF. And then most importantly, he's telling them to schedule a free strategy call. So right here, you can download the book. Over here, you can click on it and go straight to his calendar. Again, you guys, I use Kartra for my landing pages, my email automation, and my online calendar. Those three softwares alone would run me $200 to $300 a month, but I do everything in Kartra for $99 a month. Plus, again, if you activate the link in the description, you can get a 14-day trial to play around with all this before you even have to commit. So activate that trial, man. So here's the deal. When they get to this thank you page, it's him on video. It's not just text. That's another thing you guys want to do, man. Whatever you're selling, whatever you're offering, whatever you're giving away, however you're capturing a lead, when I enter my name and email and I come to a thank you page, put yourself out on video. That goes a long way. You wanna separate yourself from every Tom, Dick, and Harry. This is how you do it. Because I'm telling you one thing, man, your competition, they're not doing it. Everyone's afraid of the camera. Everyone's shy. No one's putting their face out there. Everyone wants to hide behind a logo. It's like, dude, come on. This is 2021. Like, social media branding, that transparency in who the hell you are matters. Like, that matters. Like, you got to put yourself out. And that's why I tell people all the time, man, the only reason why you guys are here on YouTube, the only reason why you're here on my channel is because of video. If I was writing some boring ass blog, none of you would be here. None of you would be reading it. My brand wouldn't be the same. But because you see my ugly mug, because you see my freaking beard that hasn't been shaved in freaking 9 months, like, because you actually see my video, my face, that's what has you guys here. It's video, man. So when you can put yourself out and put out video to your ideal prospective client, it's like, dude, it don't matter what you look like. It don't matter your hair, your color, how you talk. Like, shout out to my boy Boyan. He thinks his accent, because he's from another country, he thinks his accent hurts him when it actually doesn't, dude. I'm trying to tell you, like, it don't matter how you sound. It don't matter how you look. It don't matter about nothing. You're going to attract that percentage of the market that find you attractive for whatever reason. And I'm not talking about attractive in a sexual way. I'm talking about just doing business. I'm talking about just relating to that person, just looking at that person and saying, damn, they seem like a genuine person. I'd love to work with them. That has nothing to do with how you look, man. So in this case, his hair looks good, right? He could have a shaved head. He could have his hair, no gel in it. It wouldn't matter. Like, it wouldn't matter. He's still going to capture a percentage of the market no matter what. That's just how it is. That's why you guys on my YouTube channel, you know how many people come across my channel that probably watch my videos that don't subscribe? In fact, I'll tell you right now, 90+%, because I look at my analytics, 95+%. I think it's like 97%. 97% of people that watch my videos aren't even subscribers. Go figure. And it's like, dude, every day my subscriber count increases. the percentage of people, shout out to every single one of you, man. Those that are smashing the subscribe button, those that are loyal, that are watching my videos, my freaking family here on YouTube, my tribe. Shout out to every single one of you, because all you are is that small percentage of a huge market that's coming across some weirdo named David saying, "Hey, you know what, man? I like that guy. I can learn some shit from that guy. That guy seems cool. Let me subscribe and see what else he could put out." That small percentage is all I need. Like, it's all I need. It's all I need. So that's why I'm thankful for every single one of you. You're all I need. Like, I don't need millions of subscribers. Neither do you. You don't need millions of people to land on this page. You don't need millions of appointments. Whatever business you're in, I don't care what kind of business you're in. You don't need freaking millions of appointments all damn day. No, you don't, dude. You need a few. Like a freaking few. If you're running traffic and getting an extra freaking, if you were getting an extra two appointments a day, two ain't shit. If you were getting an extra two appointments a day, just imagine this. If you're in the service business and you're servicing people and you're out there looking for appointments, I want you to look at your calendar right now and just imagine if you had on autopilot, right? I'm talking about appointments that are being scheduled without you doing shit but running an ad, which technically you ain't doing shit in that case either. You freaking click a few buttons and then go to bed. You ain't actively prospecting. You're not actively talking to people to get people to schedule appointments. You're not hitting people in the DM to get people to schedule an appointment. You ain't doing none of that. You click a few buttons, run an ad, and you have appointments on autopilot. Imagine if you just had an extra two a day from all this shit I'm talking. If you just had an extra two appointments a day, Monday through Friday, forget about Saturdays, how would that change your life? How would that change your business? Would it change anything? Would an extra two appointments a day that actually came to you, very different than you prospecting and forcing people to schedule an appointment with you? That's different. I know all about that. I was a telemarketer for 15 plus years. I go after the business. Even how I built my agency over here since 2016, I go after the business. I've hit people in the DM and closed over 500 clients just from messaging people in the damn DM. But that's going after the prospect. I'm talking about them coming to you. I'm talking about running a Facebook ad and having them freaking come to you. If you had an extra two per day, how would that change your business? Right? That's just two. So you don't need a shitload, man. So if you follow my lead, this is basic stuff and this is powerful, dude. So that person comes here, they schedule a call. They're either going to schedule a call here. So here's where we're going to get onto it. People are either going to schedule a call here or they're going to start, they opted in. Now they're going to start receiving automated emails, educating them on what we're talking about, getting them to schedule the call then, right? Now, if they schedule a call here, they won't receive those emails to schedule a call. We'll know that through the system. But if they don't schedule the call here, then our next opportunity is to automate emails, leverage automation, automate your emails, because that's how you're going to nurture that list, build a relationship, build more trust, build more social proof, build more credibility via email automation. That's how you're going to stay in touch with all these people that are downloading this PDF. And that's how you're going to get people to schedule appointments. So it's all about getting that person something of value up front for free and then nurturing that lead after to, again, get them to either buy something or get them to schedule an appointment. And in this case, we're going for appointments, okay? So they land here. They don't schedule an appointment here. So here's what we're going to do now. Now we're going to set up our email autoresponder, because this is where the game really, really begins. Because again, to tell you the truth, majority of people are not going to schedule a call right away on this thank you page. They just saw your ad. They just downloaded your free PDF. They don't exactly know you just yet. Maybe they're just looking for information, right? So they're not going to automatically jump in the back seat and pull their pants down with you, right? That's what this is. You know, jumping in the back seat and, you know, doing the hokey pokey right away, right? Because they're just, now you have a percentage of people that land here, they will schedule a call right away because they liked you. Maybe you're retargeting them. Maybe they keep seeing your Facebook ads and they're like, holy shit, okay, let me finally download this PDF. I've seen five of his other ads. He seems like a cool guy. Let me finally download it. At that point, a person that's warm and running retargeted warm Facebook ads or Instagram ads or whatever, that person at that point might go right away and take advantage of clicking and scheduling a strategy call. But the majority of people are not. And that's why the email automation is so, so important, man. You have to be nurturing your leads. You have to be building that trust via email automation. And this is where it all starts, okay? So in Kartra, again, we started with our pages. We have over here our calendar, and then we have over here our email automation sequences. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to come in here. I'm going to hit edit. I can name the sequence. This right here, public description, this is what they see if they ever go and unsubscribe. So if a lead unsubscribes from your sequence or your email list, this is just a simple description reminding them on what list that even was, okay? So that's just like a thank you for downloading, reminding them that they actually downloaded something, right? So here's what we're going to do. We're going into the actual email sequence. Now, what I like to do is I like to put video. I like to have each email, when they click on it, they simply open up an actual page, which takes them to a video, and I'm on video explaining email number three. Right. But you don't always have to do that. You can simply let me delete this one. I'll activate it. And then all I'm going to do is just drag it. Actually, that's the complete. Okay. I'll leave right there for now. Actually, you know what? Let me delete it. But what was I saying? Yeah, I'll put myself out on video in the emails, but I mean, that's just next level stuff. You don't have to. So in this case, all I'm going to do, man, is I'm going to show you how I put together a few of these emails. So it all starts with the starting rule, right? The starting rule is and this is a form. Sometimes you got to just hover over the damn thing. There we go. Edit. Okay. This is the starting rule. So all we're doing here is telling the system who is going to start receiving these emails, right? The moment they download the PDF, what happens next, okay? And that's what we're basing off of. We're basing off of the form. Whoever fills out the form, 5 tips for restaurants, that is the form. That's the form that they fill out on the landing page. We're telling the system, whoever fills out that form, send them these next emails, okay? So here goes email number 2. And in fact, email number 1, let me double check to see where email number 1 is. It should be in the form. If it's not here in the sequence, then it will be over here in the actual form, which would be right over here. So this is one place you can put that first initial email, just the first one, right? The one that goes out immediately. They're coming to your page to download your free PDF, and then they're going to receive an email instantly the moment they enter their name and email. This is one place you can put that email. So I'm assuming it's over here. It's in my form. Let me see. What I do is I put it in the sequence. So I'll make that first, let's hit save right here. I'll make that first email, the very first initial email, I'll let it go out through the sequence. But this is a place where you can have it go out as well. And in this case, he's having it go out through the form. Okay, that's the welcome message. That's the first email they get the moment they opt in, okay? So here's what I'm gonna do. 5 tips how to use Facebook. 5 tips on how to use Facebook to get more customers. Okay, perfect. So, and you know what? Here's what I'm going to do. I'm actually going to change this. I'm going to put this down here. And I'm actually going to just simply bold this. I'm going to align it. And I'm actually going to okay, perfect. So I'm gonna just do a little edit real quick. Okay, so 5 tips on how to use Facebook to get more customers. And then up here, because that right there is like a subject line that is yelling spam, right? Like, so sometimes depending on certain email providers, that title would most likely throw that email in spam. So just to be safe, what I always try to do is make the subject line in the email a little less hypey or salesy or something like that. You know what I mean? So I'm going to use their first name. I'm going to copy first name, dynamic variable. I always use their first name in everything, the subject line, the email. I'll call them up by their first name. I'll put Jack, here's your And sometimes using the word free spams it as well. Sometimes, but that should be fine. Jack, here's your free download, just like that. And then over here, I'm going to X out this up here. Okay, so now we're clean. Okay, so here we go. So thank you so much for downloading my ebook. Five tips. Actually, there it is there. Just take this part out. I didn't see it down below. Okay, we're good. Okay, so thank you so much for downloading my ebook. Five tips. Let's bold this and let's center this. Actually, what happened? Let's just center this part right here. Okay, so five tips how to use Facebook to get more customers. Click here to download your PDF. And what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to let's get this link real quick. Okay, so here's the link for the PDF. Let's open this up and double check. Here's the link for the PDF. Now, the link sits inside of Kartra as well. So there's the link for the PDF. Okay, so now here's what we're going to do. We are going to simply take out that. I'm not gonna shoot for an appointment right now. We're not shooting for an appointment right now, B. We're simply giving them their PDF. That's it. Give, right? Jab, then I'll hook that ass, right? So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to add this down here, and I'm going to simply put this over here. This link is going to go right here. And then I'm going to put click here to download your free PDF. Okay, so, and then what I can do is I can change the color of that to maybe match his red. So we'll just go with that one. Click here because he has that red going on. So there's that. There's, let's see, are these social media icons? So those icons are not even set up. But yeah, but he'll have to do that part. Okay, so, and then let's take out these damn trees. I don't know what the hell the trees are all about. Let's take out those trees. And then what we can do, here's what I'm going to do. I'm actually going to add an image. I'm going to add an image, happy people at restaurant. How the hell do you spell restaurant? Happy people at restaurant, however the hell you spell that. Happy people at restaurant. Okay, so then I'm going to go images, and here's all I'm going to do. I'm going to go images, and then I'm just going to grab an image real quick. Let's go with, and you're looking for a crispy one, right? A crispy, clean image. Oh, that's a good one. That's a good one. Let's go with this one. Okay, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to simply grab this image, right? I'm going to grab this image. I'm going to put this image in. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to click, drag, and I'm going to drop it right below. Take out this. Right below the button, okay? Right below the button, and maybe I'll take this up. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm actually going to, let's take this out here. And again, you guys are just seeing me in the freaking flesh, man. Like you're just seeing me freaking do what I do, and I'm just taking you through it, man. Put a signature down here. So let's get that. Let's drop it down right here. Okay. So now all I'm going to do is I'm going to take this and then paste in his signature right there. That's fine. Okay, so here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna take this and let me grab the link. So look, I'm gonna grab the link for the PDF, right? And I'm also going to link it to the actual image. So I'm gonna put that right there and I'm gonna upload that image. So if they click on the image, right? Some people click on images. If they click on the image, then boom, that's going to download the PDF as well. So bam. Actually, Market Hall. Shit, I didn't see that little text right there. Let me get a different picture real quick. Let's go with... Let's go with... Okay, and some of them have like, you know, text in them, but we'll just find the ones that are clean that doesn't. Yeah, that's a good one. Let's go with... Let's go with this one. Let's go with this one. Cute little chick right there. Let's go with this one. Okay, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to come back over here. The link is already there. All I'm going to do is change out the image. So let's put that image right there. And then bam, we're good. Okay, so if they click on the image, then boom, they'll download the PDF. Okay, so just want to clean it up. Thank you so much for downloading my ebook, 5 Tips. Click the button below. So click the button below to access now. Be sure to look for my emails coming up. I'll be walking you through and teaching you Facebook ad strategies to capture more customers than you can possibly handle. Chat soon. And just something friendly, right? Something friendly, something freaking, and again, B, you can always edit this, dude. You can always edit this. I'm just kind of, and then I'll bring this up. I'm just kind of freestyling right now. But you see where I'm getting at, you know what I mean? So there's the logo, there's his button, there's the image that looks a lot better than freaking, you know, what it was before. So, okay, so here's your free download. So we're going to click save and then save and next. Okay, so now we're going to go back to the sequence. So now we're good. That first email went out through my form. Okay, so now we're in my sequences. Let's go back to the sequences. This is where the next email and the next email and the next email is going to come from, right? So this is our automation. All of it's automated, but this is where the sequence begins. Let's just put it that way. This is where your email autoresponder really begins. That first welcome message through the form, that's just the immediate one-time email that they'll get the moment they opt in. But from this point on, so what we're doing is we're going off the starting rule. One day later, and I could change that to 1 hour. I can have that go out 3 hours later. I can have that go out 10 days later. I can change the 1 days and 0 hours to whatever I want. But when it comes to dripping on your leads email, you know, via email automation, you want to maybe send out maybe one a day, maybe one every other day, right? And a lot of times people ask me, David, how many emails should I put over here? Shit, dude, I'd put together freaking 97. Like I would not all at one time. Like what you can do is you could put a few together and then maybe throughout the week, whenever you get an extra hour or so, come back in here and add more emails. Come back in here, add more emails. Next week, come back in here, add more emails. Make that shit freaking long. Because again, man, if the objective is to get them to schedule a call, right? You already know it's the right audience. They downloaded your free offer. They downloaded your free PDF. Obviously, they're interested in what you're freaking offering. They downloaded your free offer. So as long as you know that that's your ideal client, why would you want to stop communicating with them? Why would you want to stop dripping on them, right? Why would you only want 7 emails right here and then no more emails going out to them, right? Like that makes no sense. make that as long as possible, because I tell my clients all the time, that lead is either going to schedule a damn appointment, unsubscribe, or freaking die. One of the three is going to happen, man. They're either going to schedule an appointment because you got so much value and you're bringing so much content and you've been dripping on them for the past 37 days, right? And now they're finally going to schedule an appointment, or they're going to get sick and tired of your damn emails and unsubscribe, or they're going to freaking die. I don't know any other way to put it, right? Like, so it's like, make that as long as possible. Now, just to get the campaign going, we're only going to put a few right here, but eventually what I'm going to have him do is continue to go back. This is a live breathing freaking being. Like, this right here is a freaking alive. It's alive. Like, the damn thing is freaking, it's just freaking breathing for attention, right? So let that thing live. Let that thing live on forever. Put as many emails as possible on this sequence and always, you know, be in touch with that lead. Now, you want to be careful on what type of email you're putting together, because if you're writing an email, let's say you're on email number 19 and that email has to do with freaking shit that's happening in 2021. But all of a sudden it's email number, well, let's put it this way. It's email number freaking 39. And now we're in the year 2023, right? And you're talking about shit that happened in 2021 and it was an automated email. It was email number 39 and it happened to be going out for the past 39 times. But the content in that email is irrelevant now, right? So be careful when it comes to what you're writing. You want it to be evergreen. You want it to be content that is not going to outdate, right, anytime soon. Because again, that's going to give you the ability to put together freaking 57 emails, and each email is jam packed with relevant information that person can learn from, right? And again, the whole objective is to schedule a call. That's the whole objective, man. I have two objectives but here are the objectives when it comes to the email automation. To nurture that lead, I need to stay top of mind. They can't just download my PDF and then all of a sudden I don't communicate with them. They're going to forget who the hell I am. They don't even know who the hell I am, right? So don't think because they downloaded it, they all of a sudden know you. No, they don't, dude. It's a cold lead still. You have to nurture that lead. So the email automation allows you to nurture that lead, AKA build a relationship, AKA build trust, AKA build credibility, that likability, right? Where they're in the position where they're like, damn, I like that person, right? Number one, you're nurturing that list. Number two, the objective is to get them to schedule a call, or again, depending on your business, get them to buy your product, right? But again, we're scheduling calls here. So objective number two is to get them to schedule a call. So again, why would I want to stop that process? Let them emails go out. Let me keep educating and keep nurturing that lead until they schedule a call, right? So here's what we're going to do. This is the next email. The welcome email went out instantly. This one goes out a day later. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to come in here. I'm going to click on edit. And let me see if there's anything in here. And if not, then I'm going to start this one from scratch. Actually, I'll start the next one from scratch. So this is email number two. And then I'm going to come in here, email content. Now, I'll explain this, all these settings here on the next one. I'll explain it on the next one. Now, let me see if he has any templates saved. And knowing him, he has no freaking emails saved. And that's fine. Here's what I'm going to do. I am going to simply, okay, so here's what I'm going to do. Let's get rid of this one. I'm going to start over. Let's get rid of this one. Hit delete. And then what I'm going to do, done and exit, I'm going to go to that first email. Again, remember in the beginning, I said you want everything to be consistent. The aesthetics, the colors of your pages, the colors of your buttons, your footer, font, things like that, right? So email template is another one. So what I'm going to do is this first email goes out, right? Instantly. What I want is I want every email that follows to resemble and have the same template, right? The aesthetics, the paying attention to detail, that makes your brand stand out. And that's what goes a long, long way, man. You may think people don't pay attention to little shit like that. They do. So I want to use the same template. I want that same look on every email. So it all starts here. It all starts with this first email. And all I'm really doing, first of all, these icons need to be updated. They need to be updated, but we're going to have to just save it the way it is now. Actually, you know what? Let me see if I can find him. Actually, you know what? Let me see if his let me see if his Facebook is over here. Instagram. Gosh, this guy. Not all that, bro. Just that part. Okay, so just okay, so there's his Facebook page. Perfect. Okay, so let's grab this real quick. Let's grab that. And then let me just open it up to make sure it's the right page. Okay, perfect. So there's the business page. And all I'm going to do is I'm going to come back in over here, hit edit over the F, and I'm going to put in that link. Okay. And then let's see if he has any other. Actually, let's go to, I could just look at it on about, actually right here. Okay, so he has Instagram. So let's click on the Instagram. There's his Instagram. So let's go ahead and put it over here under his IG. Just paste it in there. And then let's see if he actually has a LinkedIn. Let's see if I can find him. Actually, you know what? What I need is I need just this part right here, LinkedIn. Let's see if he has a LinkedIn. Nope, he doesn't have a LinkedIn. So what I'm gonna do, bro, is I'm gonna have to just leave those ones blank for now. At least we got the other one. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna save as template. Right? I'm gonna save as template. And then I'll just be able to use that one over and over and over. Okay, so let's close out this. Let's come back up here. Let's get out of here. Save. Actually, you know what? I just saw something real quick. Okay, no, we're good. Okay, so save. Okay, cool. So save and next. Let's get out of here. Let's get out of here. Let's get out of here. Okay, so now we have that saved template. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to come back to the sequence. I'm going to come back to the sequence, click on sequences, go into edit. Click on edit. You guys, I'm telling you, man, those of you that have made it this freaking far, this is where your money's at. The thank you page, getting them to buy something or schedule a call. Your email automation, getting them to buy something or schedule a call. This is what it's all about. So if you made it this far, man, if you haven't subscribed, can you please freaking subscribe? And I encourage you, click the link in the description, profitwithkartra.online. Activate a 14-day trial and compare it to what the hell you're using to build your business online. And I'm telling you, man, it's night and day. So here's our sequence. All I'm going to do is I'm going to come up here to the top. I can send text if I'm asking for phone number up front. There's other automations, which I'll get into later, but right now we're going to keep it simple. Click, drag, and drop it down. This is the setup of our second, really are technically our second email. So what we're going to do, the moment they opt in, we're going to have this one go out the following day. Hit next. Okay, so now this is all based on when they opt in. So no matter when they opt in, no matter what time of day they opt in, that email, this email is going to go out a day later, which is 24 hours later. So I don't mess with any of the days or the times. I just leave it as is. Communication, I name it the actual name of the first email or the second email in this case. So whatever we're gonna title that actual email, I'm gonna simply name the broadcast the same thing. So let me check this right here. Congratulations on getting your free ebook. You know what? That could have been the first. Upon scheduling, I will guide you on your online presence on Facebook when that's taken care of. Okay, so here's what I'm gonna do. I'm actually gonna take this and I'll make this the next email. So I'm gonna copy this and let's just name this one congratulations. Congratulations. Is that how you spell congratulations? Congratulations. Okay, congratulations. That's the name of the broadcast. Which is just internally. That's just something you see internally. That's the communication, the broadcast, the title. But again, I can name the email whatever I want, the subject line, but I tend to leave it the same so I know exactly what email that is. So that's coming from your business email, right? Your business email. And this is the recipients. Anyone reaching this step, because it's based on that start and rule, right? So whoever opts in starts to receive these emails. So in the recipients, I just go with anyone reaching the step. So hit next, single email, next, and then here goes the content. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go advanced right here at the top, design templates, my templates, click the one we saved, drag it over and drop it. That's it, man. That's it. Now what I want to start doing is I'm going to start using this button for our calendar. That's why I have the calendar link open over here, right? So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to get calendar. And I'm going to I'll just leave the link. I'm going to copy the link and I'm going to bring that over here. So now I'm going to simply change this. Click here to download your free PDF. This is going to go in the URL, the link, and I'm going to put click here to schedule your free strategy call. Bam. Just like that, you guys. Just like that. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to simply, again, go back and copy what he has. And I'm going to put that right over here. Okay. Congratulations on downloading my free ebook. Okay. Now that was yesterday, right? That was a day ago, right? Congratulations on downloading my free ebook. The road to the growth of your business starts here. And what you want to do is you want to kind of separate. You don't want it to be a huge paragraph. You want it to be lines, right? The road. And then also what you want to do is you want to kind of bold things every now and then. The road to the growth of your business starts here. You are a few clicks away from exponentially increasing your business. Business's reach on Facebook. Now, all that is left for you to do to start this successful journey is to schedule a free one-on-one session with me. Perfect. I like it. Okay, so I'm going to take this next part, copy, and then I'll bring it down. Let's see where it makes sense. And then also, you see how the text looks a little different? This text up here is 16. This text down here is 18. So here's what I want to do. I want to freaking just do that, do one of them little shebangs and just change that to 16. Okay, so now, and then also, I always want to make sure it's the right color. So just make sure we're matching. See how it's gray? I need it black, right? So always those little things like that, man, I'm telling you, dude, before you launch your emails, those little things, you better tighten up your shit because those little things people notice. Okay. So upon scheduling, I will guide you on how to set up your business presence on Facebook. When that's taken care of, I will tell you the best practices and implementations to maximize your engagement. It will be a step-by-step process aimed at not only increasing your digital audience, but your understanding of the whole mechanism as well. If you want, I can take care of it all for you. With years of experience in the field, I provide exceptional marketing services and I deliver what I commit. So let's bring this down. So wait no further and schedule a meeting with me right away. Right away. Completely free and no hidden charges. I look forward to hearing from you. I look forward from hearing from you. Okay, so let's bold this. Let's underline that. Okay, so now here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to simply put in another restaurant image. So I want happy people at restaurant. So all I'm going to do, you guys kind of get the flow of it. I'll do one more and then I'll let you go. I'll set up one more email and then you kind of get the drift of it. But all I'm doing is I'm using the same template. I'm the emails are already pre-written, so I'm just copying and pasting them. And then I'm throwing together some cool images on each email to really make it stand out. And I'm looking for the crispiest ones, man, them clear ass freaking iPhone freaking 19 type of quality, right? Image. I'm looking for a clean image. And these are probably, be careful when you're grabbing images on Google, because some of them are copyrighted, right? But that's a clean image right there. But we're not selling the image, nor am I putting that image on a product that I'm actually selling, right? So are these pictures out there in the public that I'm promoting, right? So these are simple images that I'm taking and I'm putting in my emails. So it's like, dude, no one even cares. No one's going to see them but my lead. So I'm not worried about copyrights or anything like that. So I'm going to take away this link, and what I'm going to do in the image is I'm going to simply put in my calendar link, right? Because people, again, click on images. So if and when they do, I'll just simply take them to my calendar. Okay, so we'll put in that calendar link right there. There's the red button for the calendar. They can click on the image for the calendar. There are the social media icons, which need to be updated, but we'll do that later. And then that's the full blown email, dude. So here's what it is. And then here's what I'm gonna do. First of all, let's put this also in the subject line. Congratulations, Jack. Again, I use their first name a lot. Congratulations, Jack. Perfect. Okay, cool. So now here's what we're going to do. Email is good. I can always send a test email. In fact, you know what? Let me do that real quick. Send test email. Let's go with... Okay, so let's just check my email real quick, and I'll show you how that email came out. And this is what you want to do all the time too, man. You want to test your buttons, test the button, test the image, make sure you know it takes you. I could have did that on the PDF one as well, but it's all good. I'll just do it here. We'll just come in here. We'll get that first email. Okay, so. Oh, that's cool. I didn't even notice that. 9:30 a.m. 500. Shout out to freaking Next Step Realty. Awesome. Thank you, God. Okay, cool. That's awesome. Okay, so here's the first one. Congratulations test. Bam. Congratulations test. So this is it right here. So congratulations on downloading my free ebook. So blah, 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 blah. Boom. Click here. And boom. It takes you straight to the calendar. Click on the image. Bam, it brings you straight to the calendar. That's it right there, you guys. That's it right there. So now we're going to X out of this. We sent the test email, right? So we're good there. We're good there. Now all we're going to do is come back up to the top, hit next. We don't need any automations just yet. I'll teach you that later. Create, and we're good. So now here's what we got to do next. We need to activate the email. So all we're going to do is we're going to hover over over the dots. We're going to hit activate. We're going to connect the line. We're going to hit this up here, arrange items, and we're going to go off and set up our second email. Just like that, you guys. Now, again, I could have had that welcome email come out here and be the first email, but we're having to go out through the actual form, and that's fine. So this one's going to go out a day later, right? Actually, you know what? So that one went out a day later. This one goes out a day later from the previous one. So we're going to go 2 days later. 2 days later, from the previous one. So every other day, right? 2 days later, next, don't worry about any of that one. And this one, this next one, I'm going to title, oh no. This one's going to be oh no, right? This is number two. So perfect. Okay, so this is going to be, the title of this one's going to be oh no. Oh no. Okay, so next, coming from the right email, next. And again, this one's going to be anyone reaching this step. Click on add. Click on next. Single email. Next. And then here goes the setup of the next email. And again, I'm going advanced. I'm going design templates. I'm going to grab my template and throw it over. Bam. So here's what I'm going to do. This one right here is oh no. And these subject lines, you want them to be short, catchy, and throw people off. Like this person's going to open up their email box and they're going to be like, oh no, what the hell's oh no? Right. And then they click on it. Like, I always want those subject lines to be cliffhangers and just kind of throw people off. Right. So they end up, I end up getting their attention and they end up clicking on it and opening the damn email. Right. So here's all I'm gonna do. I'm gonna come over here. I'm gonna grab this text. We're gonna grab all this. We're gonna grab all this. Grab all this. Okay. So we'll copy that. We'll bring it over. And let's paste it in. Control V on a PC. Control V on PC. Okay. And then I'm going to simply make sure that this is spaced. And also the text on our previous one was 16. So I want to make sure that this is 16 as well. This is 18, right? So what I want to do is I'm going to highlight everything. I'm going to make sure that we're in the right color. Let's make sure it's black. And then I'm going to go 16. Right? 16 for everything. 16. So there we go. Okay. So that's a lot of text, but it's all good. And that's what he wants. And we'll leave it that way. I'm going to leave it that way. I'm not even going to mess with it no more. So this is 18. Okay. So the top is 16. Let me change this again. So this is going to be 16. Okay, good. We're good. Okay. So here's what we're going to do. Now, because this is the next email, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to get rid of this other template, and I'm going to save this one right here. Actually, you know what? Damn it. I should have saved the other one. Here's what I'm going to do. Let me change this real quick. I'm going to save this one. So I should have saved the other one. That's fine. The second one with the calendar, with the other image, booking, going to the calendar, but that's fine. I'll do it here. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to put in that. Click here to schedule your free strategy call. Okay, click here to schedule your free strategy call. And then again, this is the third email. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to happy people at restaurant, and I'm going to go images, and let's just grab another image. So let's grab something that looks clean and fun. Let's go with this one. Okay, so all I'm going to do is I'm going to download it, bring it over here, take out this little hottie right here, upload image. Bam, I'll put that one. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to save this template because this one has the click here to schedule your free strategy call. That one has that link. So I want that one. Let me get this link, copy, edit the image, put that calendar link in there. And again, I can always send test email. And then what I'm going to do, I'm going to save this template. Okay. You still haven't scheduled your free strategy call. Okay, so here's the deal. Here's what I'm about to teach you right now. This right here is powerful. Okay, this is what's super powerful. Okay, so here's what I gotta do. Let me save this real quick. Okay, that becomes our new template, right? That becomes our new template, and we're going to rock with that one. And again, all we're going to do is use the same red button, the same social media icons, the same image slot. We're going to just change out our image, you know, on every email, right? So it's a different look. So here's what I want to do now. Oh no, you still haven't scheduled your free step-by-step strategy call. Now, how do we know that? What if they did, right? What if they did? Here's how you work the system. This right here is freaking powerful. So we go to create. Now here's what I want to do. Let me activate this real quick and then I'll show you what to do. This is going to be based on a tag. So I'm going to hover over the dots. I'm going to activate. I'm going to drag down, put it right below. I'm going to connect it. And then I'm going to arrange items. Now here's the deal. Here's what's super, super important. You got to hover over these dots, go back into it, edit. Now remember, the recipients, I chose anyone reaching this step. That's going to change. Okay. That's going to change. We got to change this and we got to put in a tag. So it's not anyone reaching the step anymore. Now that I really think about it, I'm glad I caught myself there. It's not that. It's going to be anyone who does not have tag. So if they do not have the tag scheduled appointments, send them this email. Okay. So I may have to create that tag. Restaurant category. Actually, you know what? It's going to be no category. It's going to be any appointment, whatever. Okay. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to create tag. Okay. So this right here, tag name is scheduled appointments. Appointments. Okay. I use that as the tag name and I'll use that as the description. Okay. And then I'll just leave no category because it's not exactly the restaurant. It is the restaurant campaign we're working on, but at the same time, it's that calendar tag, that scheduled appointment tag, it's going to apply for anybody scheduling an appointment. So I'm going to just leave it general. Okay. So no category in particular. And I'm going to click create. Okay. So here's the deal. Now I'm going to add it. Okay. I'm going to add it. I just created it. Now I'm going to add it. That is going to become the recipient setting for every email from this point on. Okay. For those who do, and you know what? To tell you the truth, I got to go back and do that on the first email as well, the congratulations, because if they went to the landing page and downloaded the free PDF, then they go to the thank you page and actually schedule the appointment on that thank you page. This email over here, this first one is going to go out a day later. It's based on the start and roll, right? It's based on the start and roll. And in fact, you know what? Here's what I'm going to do. I'll leave it opt-in form. And because what I can do, I can also add a tag, add a start and roll up here based on a tag. So look, it's going to be based on the opt-in form, but it's also going to be based on the tag. So these emails are only going to go out. They're only going to go out. Let's go. They're only going to go out if, actually, you know what? I'm not going to do it here. I'm going to do it on the first email. Congratulations. So the start and roll is the opt-in form. But as one day later comes around, congratulations, we're going to update the recipients. This email is only going to go out. It's not anyone reaching this step. It's only going to go out if they do not have that tag. So if this lead does not have the scheduled appointment tag, then send them this email. Okay. So that becomes the recipient setting for all of these emails. Because again, our objective is to get them to schedule a call and schedule an appointment. I don't want to keep sending these emails if that lead has already scheduled an appointment, right? Because that's the whole objective with these emails, man, is to stay top of mind, nurture the lead, but get them to schedule a call. That's why I'm freaking emailing them, right? It's like, shit, we're in business. We got to get people on the damn phone, right? So that becomes the new recipient, okay? If they don't have that tag, send them this email. And that's how you do it, you guys. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the two emails and I'm going to take it to freaking 22. I don't want to bore you to death any longer than I may have already bored you, but shout out to every single one of you. If you made it this far, freaking subscribe, dude, subscribe, smash the bell for notifications and drop me a comment below. Let me know what you guys are working on and let me know how I can bring value to what you're doing online. This is all real deal, holy field type of day in the life, you know, documenting what I'm doing for clients and friends and for my own business. And I just try to bring value and keep it simple for you guys, man. So Facebook advertising, social media marketing, landing pages, email automation, that's what you're going to catch on this channel, right? So shout out to every single one of you for making this far. Thank you so much. I hope you got value out of this one. All I'm going to do is I'm going to come over here, send email. I'm going to simply drag it down and I'm going to work on my third email. That's it, you guys. So once we're done here, then all I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure that I hit the done and exit. Let me just go through this one real quick, you guys. I'm going to just hit that done and exit because that's so, so important. Next communication. Let's name it the third. I forgot to put that part, but you know what? I'll go back to it. You have tried everything and still struggling. So I'm going to go still struggling. That's going to be the name of this one. Still struggling. Is that how you spell struggling? Still two G's. Okay, so still struggling. Still struggling. Okay, so next, that's the email it's coming from and being send and reply. Send if does not have tag, right? So if they still haven't scheduled an appointment, send them this email. Okay, so now here's what I'm going to do. Hit next. Single email, next. I'll just do this damn email for you guys. So again, advanced, design templates, grab our template, bring it over. There goes our Oh No template. The button's already updated. The image, all I gotta do is just change out the image. The link is already there, but let's go ahead and just copy this. Copy. And then come up here and remember our font size. Always remember our font size, 16. So we're going to take this, Control V on PC, and there it is there. So I'm going to simply take this to 16. Okay, so let's space that. Let's space that and let's space this. Okay. Okay, so let's bold this real quick. Underline that. Okay, so I'm gonna put still struggling. Okay, still struggling. Okay, so here's what I'm gonna do. The link is there. Let me just change out the damn image real quick. Let's go with this one right here. That's a cool image. Okay, so let's go with this one. Download. Where are we at? Okay, so it's already linked, right? The image is already linked. Now all I got to do is just simply, there's our calendar, simply change out the image and we are good. So there's that. Okay, so we're good there. Link, everything is linked. Okay, so all we're gonna do is come up here, hit next, hit create. And then again, we're gonna hover over the dots, activate it and connect it. So let's hover over these dots right here. Let's activate. Let's drag it down. You always want to drag it down, right? Drag it down. Make them things line up and look pretty. Here we go. Right here, we're going to connect it. Bam, bam. Arrange icons, and that's it. And if I want to go back into any previous email, just hit edit. And I actually do. Let me just do this part real quick. So I'll come in and then boom, there's everything, right? I can always change the delay. I can always edit any of this stuff, man. None of it is carved in stone. I can change whatever the hell I want. But again, always make sure that this is your business email, not your Gmail, not your freaking Yahoo. That needs to be a .com, your own .com. That's very, very important for the emails. Okay, so I'm going to come in here, email content, and I'm going to simply add what I forgot to add on that second email. So it's this part right here. Okay, so let's add that real quick. So just come up here to the pink pencil. Okay, so we're already there. So let's go, let's click down here. Control V on PC. And we are good. So again, 16 is what we're working with. Let's change this to 16. Schedule your free, I look forward. Bam. There it is there, man. Come up here, hit edit. And here's what you want to do also, man. Never leave this idling, right? So I click it, I save it, and then it brings me back to the dashboard, to the settings right here. And then I'm going to X out right here. I'm going to close this out. I'm going to close this out right here. So let's let it load, close. Never leave it idling like this, right? Don't just leave it here and then freaking, you know, go to the restroom or whatever. Always hit done and exit. Done and exit on your pages and on your email sequences. Hit done and exit because you don't want to risk losing any of that stuff, right? So that was that, man. That was that, you guys. I told you, man, I warned you in the beginning of me longer than normal video, but this is a full-blown tutorial on how to get more appointments, man, how to nurture that lead, how to build trust and credibility and social proof and get people to like you. Because you're delivering content and value to people who are interested in what you're freaking selling. You're gonna do it through email automation. Okay. So email automation, and also by capturing audiences, custom audiences through your Facebook pixel. So if any of you guys are into Facebook advertising, I put together a free FB ads cheat sheet, kind of listing the top audiences that you have to start creating in order to really profit off of Facebook advertising. That's a huge thing that most people miss is the fact that your Facebook ROI is in retargeting the custom audiences of people who are engaging in your previous shit. So if I watched your video, I better be in a custom audience. If I landed on your landing page but didn't opt in, I better be in your custom audience. If I landed on your landing page, opt in, and go to your thank you page, I better be in your custom audience. So right below in the description, fbadscheatsheet.com. Download that free cheat sheet, man. I put that together. It's a list of all these different audiences that you want to set up before you start running Facebook ads, man. It's going to save you an arm and a leg just in your budget alone and help you bring your information to the most relevant people on Facebook. So I'm either going to hit you through email automation, or I'm going to hit you by retargeting through Facebook ads. Okay, so those are the two components, man. I tell people all the time today, in 2021 and beyond, Facebook advertising and Kartra. It's all you need. That's all we need to be doing, man. If you're a small business owner building anything online, paid traffic, Kartra. That's all we need. So again, there's a link for a 14-day trial, you guys. Profit with Kartra.online. I hope you guys got value out of this one, and I will see you on the next video. Over and out.